Hi guys, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I'm just doing a rabbit update. Some of people have asked about Lena's bunnies, and there has been a change. We've moved them. They've got a bigger area. These are the cages right by the door. They're the biggest cages we have, and we like to put does with litters here. But the rest of Lena's rabbits are in her new space, and I'll show that to you. Now, this used to be where Lena's rabbit tree was, right next to the goats, this little half stall. Excuse the babies, they're getting weaned. They're not very happy. But she quickly outgrew this, and so we moved her to the stall next door. Okay, this is where Lena is now. She has a full stall, which is 10 by 12. These are all her show traveling cages stacked up. And eventually we'll have more cages here. We're slowly buying them. And we give the rabbits floor time, which is nice because she's in a bigger area so they can run around, especially little fat bunnies that are a little bit overweight. So, and this is Ranger, her favorite buck, her very first American Fuzzy Lap. And he's a senior buck. The top of the weight scale on these guys is 4 pounds, so they're considered a dwarf breed. And Ranger has 4 legs. And Lena, explain what a leg is.
A leg is when you win your class. But in order to win a leg, you must have 3 different exhibitors and at least 5 rabbits.
In the class.
In the class. Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about going to American Rabbit Breeders Association shows.
Mm-hmm. You cannot win a leg through 4-H or FFA shows.
Yep. Good. And the fuzzy laps are broken down into 2 different categories, the solid colors and the broken colors, which would be white and a solid color. And Lena has how many colors in your rabbit tree?
I generally have blues, blue quartz, blacks. I believe that is it. I used to have a chocolate, but I didn't.
And you have both varieties.
Right, in brokens and solids, because it's really hard to just breed for solids or just breed for broken, because if you go far enough back in the pedigree, you will find different brokens and solids.
Yep.
Hey, buddy.
And the torts would be this color. They're kind of dark faces, and they usually have lighter bodies. They're kind of a brownish taupey color, and they can be really light or really dark. But when they're deciding colors, I've learned that they go by the faces, because the long-haired coat can be different. Now, he's grayish color, but they consider him
a blue.
And then they have blue torts, which is different yet.
I have a blue tort down there.
Oh, yeah. They're kind of brownish. They're really taupey colored, but anyway.
It's like a mix between the two.
Yeah, between the two. And then the black is self-explanatory, and then there's chocolates.
Chocolates are
sable point.
I do have 1 sable point, but he's molting right now.
He's molting. He looks terrible.
Don't
he's
look at him.
Camera shy right now. There's quite a few colors. There's rarer colors
Fuzzy
than what
Lops
we have.
Fuzzy Lops have a lot of colors because they come from Holland Lops. There's so many colors.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
Yep.
He's sweet.
He's cute. And let's see. And as far as show quality versus pet quality, What are some things that would keep a rabbit off the table?
For Fuzzy Lops, solid colors must have all their toenails matching. So if a rabbit has white toenails on 1 foot, or even just 1 white toenail, but they have dark colored toenails on the other feet or other toenails, that will mean the rabbit cannot be shown. Another thing is for brokens, when you're talking about markings, you have to have eye spots, nose markings, dark colored ears, and white front feet, and again, toenails must match, but brokens are a little different. You can have, as long as 1 full foot is all the same color, it can be different colors.
Oh, interesting. I didn't know that. Now, we do have a little baby. She's so cute, and it's the only one we've had so far like this. She's a broken, but she doesn't have any nose markings, so that would keep her off the show table. There's nothing wrong with her. Somebody could use her for a brood doe, but yeah.
Of course, she has exceptional body type. So.
Yeah, she everything else on her is really nice, so she's trying to decide what to do with her exactly. Okay, and let's see. What else you want to talk about? Here's something that can apply to all rabbit breeding. Why don't you show that little Josie?
Come here, buddy.
This can happen if you have a very small litter of any breed, especially if you have a doe that's a really good mama. And what will happen if you have one, two, three bunnies in your litter, the mama will overfeed them. Now, rabbits only nurse usually once a day, but their milk is really rich. And then you'll have a mama that will jump in there multiple times. And if she has a really small litter, she can overfeed the babies, their bellies get too big, and then you get what they call splay leg. And this little girl, you can see her legs are coming out to the side. That's what she has. Now, she gets around just fine. She's perfectly healthy otherwise, but she was
not in pain.
She's not in pain. She was a litter of two, and then she lost her sibling. And by the time we figured out what was going on and we fostered her onto another litter of four, she already had the front leg thing going on. Mm-hmm. Now, you can Google this. There are some people that say if you splint them and if you do this and that. And I think if you're talking a pet bunny situation where you can devote a lot of time and energy to it, in a rabbitry situation with, you know, 30 bunnies, probably not going to happen. So that's something to be on guard for if you have a very small litter. And how, what you can do to prevent it, if you can't foster the babies to another bunny that's nursing, another doe, you can take the whole nest box away from mama and only put it in once a day. Like supervised nursing, basically. And that will prevent this too. So, unfortunately. Another thing that will keep the bunny off the show table is if they get too big. Mm-hmm. And we've discovered at some shows, it depends on the judge. Some judges weigh every bunny, and others seldom weigh a bunny, only if it's, they are really suspicious this rabbit's severely overweight. And when I say severely overweight, I'm talking half a pound because it's a rabbit. Now, and it tends to, does are notorious for getting too big for the show table, especially after they've had babies. And that doesn't necessarily mean they're a bad rabbit. You put them, you know, we have a great big doe up there.
Don't show Hocus. I know.
But she's a great mama. She produces really nice babies. And she's a good brood doe. And she tends to have larger litters because she is bigger. But, like, these two are seniors. They're brother and sister. There's one there. And then the sisters over there, Pepsi and
Coca-Cola.
And so they're running off some extra ounce poundage. And that's the other reason we wanted to get Lena in here is we like to give the rabbits floor time. Just run around play time. Especially when they're like in these little cages and they're a litter growing out. Or to work off some weight.
Yeah.
And so that's something to think about. I really personally do not like the whole rabbits in little cages thing. I hate that. But... So you try to find the compromise, and what we've found is, you know, having a big enough area that we can close off, and then they can run around in, and she'll put hay down for them, and this, that, and there's mats in here, so they can't dig out, so.
One already tried.
Yeah, they tried. We have the door blocked off, so they can't go out under the door. So, where she'll be going to a rabbit show in Kalamazoo next weekend, and then we'll be going to MSU Thanksgiving Day weekend.
And we're possibly going to Mason the first weekend in November.
Or January.
Nope, November.
Oh, well that, dad.
Dad.
Oh, dad will take her. Yeah, her dad is taking her to this next rabbit show. He's never gone to a rabbit show, so this, we're kind of giggling over that. Because one thing I had to do in here, you can't see it, but I've got chicken wire up there because we had to keep the pigeons out of here. The pigeons were just wrecking the rabbitry over there. I mean, their feathers get everywhere, their poop, and this is their favorite stall to roost in, so we had to bar them and keep them out. We actually caught the pigeons with a fishing net. We'd hold it up there. We had pigeon fishing going on. We caught all 9 of them. I started out with 5. They moved in, and they were up to 9. We caught them, and we relocated them 10 miles away. And the very next day, 7 of the 9 pigeons were back. So apparently all pigeons have very strong homing instincts. And Lena looked it up and said, oh, Mom, they've been known to come back from being 1,100 miles away. So I think we're going to stay blessed with pigeons. I'm not going to eat them. I'm not, you know, I might get to a point in my life where I'm eating pigeon, but so far, no, not going to eat them. But for now, they're regulated to that side. And that'll be good enough. So there's a new rabbit tree. We have a little shelf here for all her other stuff, and that's her grooming table that folds up. You take it to shows, and so she's doing pretty well. She sold some rabbits off her website, they from out of state, and she has people that are going to meet us at the show and pick up bunnies, so she's starting to do pretty well. It takes about, I think, 5 years from what we understand to get established as a rabbit breeder in a particular breed. And she's only a couple years in. 3 years in?
Two
years in. So, you know, we're hoping someday to break even. But, and she gets about, for the bucks that are showable, as far as we know, mm-hmm. She gets about $25 to $30. And then for the does, the little does, she'll get about $35. Mm-hmm. And then some of the bigger farms or big names or whatever that are well known in the breed, they'll get upwards of $100 for their babies.
I saw one that was $300.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was a really
proper. So we're not looking to be to that level, but yeah, we just want to produce some nice bunnies and get a nice reputation and mm-hmm. have fun with it. And that's what we're doing so far.
And promote the breed.
And promote the breed, because we really like these guys.
Yes. Oh. What are you doing?
Sit down, having fun. That's right. Run those ounces off.
Yeah.
Run those ounces off. It's like a little treadmill in here.
Thought about letting the cat loose and run them
too. No, I don't. Well, yeah, like they would run from the cats. I don't think so. And in case everyone's wondering, we still have Will Ferrell, or Free Willy, or whatever his name is. William. He is still roaming the barn. He's 3 years old. And you want a cookie? Come out for a cookie.
Come on. Come here.
Come out for a cookie. Yes. But he'll still sell his soul for a cookie. This is the litter. Did I show this litter? I think I did. Oh, show the one that doesn't have the nose thing.
Hey, baby. You gotta move. Little black boy. You gotta move.
Come on, babies. One thing, if you're raising like the dwarf breed or the pet breed, you kind of have to really handle them because, you know. But see, isn't she cute? She's so cute. Oh, I got this zoomed in. But she doesn't have a mustache or any nose markings, so she's
She'd
not.
She'd even be showable if she had like a dot.
If she had a dot. It doesn't have to be all her nose. She is. Doing? Oh my goodness.
She's excited.
Yes. She is a broken blue, which means gray and white. But they don't call them gray. They call
You're
them
beautiful.
Blue. Yeah. She's got everything else going for her. I'm mm-hmm. way too close. Except for that stupid nose marking.
She has a nice body, yep. good ears, good head.
We've never had one without it, so I guess there's always a first time. Does the other one have a little white foot, though?
No.
No.
Ah. How's the other litter?
Oh, okay. We had one with a white foot that was,
That's still in the rabbit tree.
Oh, is it? Okay. Okay. We won't talk about where that one might be going. You do have to cull mm-hmm. when you're breeding and trying to get show quality, because otherwise you wind up with 40,000 rabbits.
Okay.
Yep. All you see is feet. Little fluffy feet.
Yep.
Okay, guys. Really signing off now. Oh, Lena, not on its head.
That's why they always go back.